Hello, hello, welcome back. Today we are expanding our knowledge of multiplying and those foundational skills that are really going to make us pros when we get into multiplying our big digit numbers and multi-digit numbers. And we are going to dig into the next step of that, which is estimating products. Now, estimating products is going to sound like two words that we really don't know how that relates to math. All it means is we are using rounding to make a estimation of the answer to our multiplication problems. So when we are being asked to estimate on a test, it might look something like this. Estimate 6 times 872. If they ask you this question, or if someone is being asked to estimate, that means we are going to round. So the first thing I want to do is remind myself that when they say estimate, they really mean they want me to round to make my job easier. Because remember our rounding video, we talked about the reason we round is to make big numbers easier to work with. Well, we're going to do the same thing here. So when we are being asked to estimate, we are rounding. So our first step when we are solving a problem like this, step number one, we're going to round our big number in the problem. In this case, 872 is our big number. We don't need to worry about rounding 6 because if we rounded it, it wouldn't change. It's already a single digit number. So we round 872. Now you might be asking, but wait, Miss Nick, what place value do we round it to? They didn't tell us. And you're right, they normally will say round to the tens, round to the hundreds, round to the thousands. When you are rounding to estimate, you always round to the biggest place value. Let me say that one more time. When we are rounding to estimate, we always round to the biggest place value. So in this situation, since 8 is in the hundreds place, the hundreds is our biggest place value, and that's the number we're gonna be rounding to. So if I round 872, that's gonna turn into what number? If I round 872 to the hundreds place, because that's the biggest place value in this number, can anyone tell me what answer I'm going to get? Chris Mary? Now let's look, that's a good guess, but we have to remember our neighbor next door, that helper, is 7. So if it's 5 or more, what do we need to do? I need to raise the score. So that means this 8 needs to raise up to a 9, and everything after it turns into zeros. So first things first, all I've done is round my big number, 872, to an easier number to work with, 900. Step number two, I multiply. I'm gonna multiply 900 times my original factor, which was 6. And now here's where our multiplying with zeros lesson is gonna come in handy. We've already learned when we multiply with zeros, we start by multiplying the digits and adding the zeros at the end. So our step number three is going to be to finalize our product. So our finished product is 9 times 6. So who can tell me what 9 times 6 is? Can someone raise their hand and fill me in on 9 times 6?
54.
54, very good. So I put my 54 down. And then I have 2 zeros in my original factor, in my original question. 2 zeros means I put 2 zeros at the end. So 1, 2. So if I'm estimating 6 times 872, my answer is going to be 5,400. So hopefully this clears up any confusion you might have about how to use rounding to estimate the product of factors like these. Please practice this on your own. If you need to rewind and rewatch, go for it. Practice, 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 and as always, ask your math teacher if you need any help at all. Have a great afternoon, and I'll see you in class.